Photoshop has recently been putting a lot of focus on artificial intelligence. It's no longer just about erasing things with a brush or cutting and pasting elements manually. One of the standout features Adobe introduced is called Generative Fill. With this tool, you can select a part of your image, type in what you want to add, and the AI generates it for you. One of the most interesting uses of this feature is the ability to add hair. Yes, you can actually take a photo of someone without hair and generate a version with hair. In the past, adding realistic hair involved hours of work with hair brushes, shadow adjustments, and fine detailing. Now, you can achieve your desired look in just a few clicks. Some people are even using this feature to get an idea of what they might look like after hair transplant. It helps them visualize different styles and decide what suits them best, all without undergoing the actual procedure. To use this feature, you will need an updated version of Photoshop from 2023 or later. Also, your computer must be connected to the internet because the AI processing happens on Adobe's servers. It's all done in the cloud, not locally on your machine. Now, let's go through the steps for adding hair. Open the photo in Photoshop, preferably one where the face is clearly visible. From the toolbar on the left, choose the lasso tool and make a selection over the area where you want to add hair. For example, draw a selection across the top of the forehead, and if you are going for a longer hairstyle, include the area behind the ears as well. The key is to select a wide enough area based on the hairstyle you plan to add. The more precise your selection, the better the results. Once you have made your selection, click the Generative Fill button. In the text field that appears, describe the type of hair you want, including details like color, length, and style. It is best to write your prompt in English to get the most accurate results. For instance, if you want to add short black hair, simply type black hair. After typing your prompt, click the Generate button. The system is entirely powered by AI. Photoshop analyzes elements like lighting, shadows, and facial structure in the image to make the edit content look as realistic as possible. Once the process is complete, the AI offers three different hairstyle suggestions. You can view and choose among them in the Properties panel. Even though these styles are based on the original bald image, they often look surprisingly realistic and well integrated. That's the power of Adobe's AI at work. What you write in the Generative Fill prompt box is crucial, as the AI generates the hairstyle based on your description. The clearer and more detailed your prompt is, the better the results will be. Let's try something else. I will delete the current style. We already saw how good the short hair looked. Now I will undo the deletion to bring back the selection. This time, let's add curly brown hair. I type that into the prompt and click Generate. That's the basic idea of adding hair. Through a few examples, you will see what is possible. Here is the curly hairstyle. As before, the AI gives us three variations each time. If none of them look good, you can click Generate again to get three new ones. And here come two fresh options. Just to remind you, the original image is bald. Yet with the AI's help, the final results are incredibly realistic. Let's move on to a new example. I undo everything and this time type in keywords that describe long straight blonde hair. You can play around with these prompts however you like. The results are often very realistic and surprisingly fun. Here is the long blonde hair style. Based on the selection we made, the AI calculated the best possible match and showed us these results. Now I type in Buzzcut, which means very short hair, and there it is. The system generated a Buzzcut version of the same image. Next, I wanted to try adding wavy dark hair, and the AI produces a great version of that as well. You can also add extra details to your prompts. Let's try something with bangs. I typed in messy curly hair with bangs. Maybe the bangs didn't turn out quite the way I expected. Perhaps due to the selected area, but the messy curls look great. Now, I try a slicked back hairstyle. After clicking Generate, the AI presents that look as well. The more detailed your prompts are, the more creative the AI becomes. But keep in mind, if the prompts are too detailed, the results can sometimes be a bit odd. That's why a bit of trial and error often helps you get the best outcome. Did you like the results? The AI made hairstyles look really real. Sometimes they are so good that people don't even notice they are fake. But they are not always perfect. Sometimes the hair looks a bit fake or like a wig. In some photos, especially from weird angles, the hair might go in the wrong direction. You might even see hair growing from the middle of the forehead. Still, if you try once or twice, you can usually get a very natural look. See you in the next video.